baby. That's really under a London. Shaman 3x3. Right now I'm doing the dual call with my man, iPodKingCarter. And right now we're just going to discuss the March 27th card on the URL. All the battles that went on that night. Just our personal thoughts and views on what we thought about the battles and whatnot.
Yes, sir.
Carter, what up, man?
I'm chilling, man. You know me. Just falling back, making vids, trying to get my name out there to these people.
Yeah, well, I'm trying to do the same thing. I'm trying to catch up to y'all.
Yeah, it's not hard, man. As long as you got the drive, you know, and the right promotion, you'll go far.
Yeah, that's just what I'm trying to do right now. So, I mean, you know, without further ado, we're going to jump right into it. The first card of that night was... What's the first video they put up on YouTube? It was Goods and
First Humble. Video, yeah, the first, very first video that they put out was Hollow Don vs. Goods. First off, Hollow won the toss, and he chose to go first against Goods. So that was a very, very crazy strategy. Not too many people that win coin tosses choose to go first. So, you know.
Yeah, I did always notice that. Like, no one ever really wants to go first. I guess they want to see what they're up against to see if they're really going to come hard or they're not.
You know? Right.
So it's like, it's an advantage, but it's also a disadvantage at the same time, depending on who you're facing.
Yeah. if you defending yourself against a hard hitter, you might not want to do that.
Exactly.
But we'll get to that a little bit later. Let's talk about this battle. All right. What's your outlook on it?
I'm gonna say I'm undecided, and I say that because Goods never got to go through his third round. His first round was good. Second round, I'm lost interest. Third round, it was an incomplete battle. Wasn't it?
Okay, I'll give you that. Well, to me, the first round was a draw. And the only reason that the first round was a draw is because Hollow came with his bars. Never stopped rapping. He was going. But Goods was spitting some real shit. But he had his crew niggas helping with his bars. And he stopped rapping and laughing too much. So that messed up his whole, you know what I'm saying, his whole W of that round. I just think it was a draw. Like, the punchlines that Goods was coming with was crazy. But in the end, he was laughing too much, joking. And his whole crew just helping him, like, finishing his bars. You can't finish that man bars. Let him rap. You know what I mean?
No, you're absolutely right. Another thing I didn't like was, like you said, like, he was laughing. Like, he was playing with the bars. Meanwhile, Hollow the Don was serious. He like, yo, this ain't no game. Like, what's up?
I'm here for the money.
Yeah, so if I had to call a winner on that battle, even though it was incomplete, I would have to give it to Hollow because he stepped it up.
Yeah, to me, Hollow won the second. He freestyled. And to tell you the truth, Goods forgot his bars in his verse. When he was talking about, when he had him in the headlock and talking about take this sweat, what are you talking about? The crowd lost all type of interest. The whole crowd was like, what?
Yeah, after that.
And he took somebody else's verse. See, I don't see, people need to watch the old battle. He took somebody else's verse. They gonna show you that. If anybody that's watching this video watch the actual battle, you'll see that. And he tried to use the same type of rhymes about how Hollow says how he raps and all that. Like, this guy is a masterful guy. Like, come on, you can't do that two rounds straight.
Yeah, that was crazy. That's why if I had to judge it, I would have to say you
know. Oh, and then third round. Oh, man, Hollow won by a landslide. Yo, if you look at the tape, the nigga that was behind Goods was talking about, damn, his bars was crazy. Yeah, that shit was crazy. And then Goods and his crew trying to laugh about a line that Hollow said about his lug / Tim's. But them niggas look lame. Like, how you gonna laugh all hard when the boy rapping? Like, you knew he took the loss, man. Matter of fact, you know what? Let's just move on, man. X Factor and Sue Surf. What's your outlook on that video, man?
Might as well hold you up. Out of all the battles that night, the Sue Surf shit was the best. Like, the Sue Surf for X Factor was the best battle. And I know a lot of people probably not gonna like what I'm about to say, but not my problem. Surf bodied this nigga.
Woohoo! Yeah, he did, man. Real talk. All right, look, this is how the battle went. In my eyes, X Factor won the toss, right? And he chose to go first like an asshole. How you gonna win a toss and say, I'll go first? Like, he ain't say the words. He tried to use body language like, man, I'm the shit. I'm going first.
Not even. He looked at it like he came into the battle like, yo, I'm a vet. Who is this poop putt? Like, I'm going first. You know what I mean? Show him what it is. And it's like, don't get me wrong. X Factor had hot moments throughout that whole battle.
Yeah.
But he didn't body one round. Like, you're supposed to be a quote unquote vet. How you don't body at least one round? Surf bodied you every round.
Every round.
Like, if you notice how all the other battles, like, if you watch how what they talk about and how they go at other rappers.
Right.
Surf's whole focus was X Factor.
All day.
That was his whole focus. The only time he brought up another rapper was at the end of his first verse when he said, tell K-Sean I do the zipping around here, which was crazy retarded.
Crazy. Had the crowd going crazy. Listen, X Factor didn't know what he was getting into in the first round. That's why he lost it straight out. Then in the second round, which was X Factor's best round, he tried to give his all the second round.
So
he still lost that. Man, Sue Surf put that boy in a body bag, zipped him up, shipped him to Maryland, and put him on ice. Crazy.
To me, that whole battle was over when after X Factor did that whole shit about the whole Midwest. But then when he said, I'll put X on the screen like I bowled the strike, the battle was over after that.
Yo, listen, he said, find X up at the top of the corner like you're trying to close the page. Like, what?
Yo.
Yo, he said, niggas looking for X, but they only found a V because I only left the upper half. Like,
he was bodying him. Like, he was saying so much shit. Like, nobody couldn't really catch up. Like, the one line he said about when he was like, smack asking what I thought about X. I said, oh, hugs and kisses. He goes, he goes, I shouldn't even spit that. That's why I'm underrated now, because there's no telling when y'all going to get that. Like, he's OD.
Yo, also, to me, to tell you the truth, I thought the third round was a draw only because it took Sue Surf halfway until his raps to get the crowd. Like, the crowd was kind of, like, iffy. And then halfway through that rhyme, they just started going behind him. Like, you know, X Factor, he had the whole crowd the whole third round for him because he was spitting bars of other people's stuff. And so he was putting it together, trying to get a little bit of crowd activity. And it was pretty good, but he still lost, hands down. Let's move on. K-Sean and Calico. Woo! K-Sean and Calico.
I'm not gonna hold you up. Nah, man. I gave this one to Calico.
You know what? I gave it to Calico, too.
Reason I say that, round one, K-Sean first round to me was whack. Like, he could have did way
better. The name is Terrainio.
Like Tsunami Sir said, that was hella filler. Said the nigga name 20 times and lost. We heard you the first time.
And he choked the second round. Calico choked the second round. You can't say it. You can't say he didn't choke.
Yo.
He tried to be like him. He tried to rhyme like him.
When you
coming at a rapper like that, you gotta come with it 100%. And he choked.
No, I agree. I mean, he slipped. He stumbled. A choke is when it's like, damn, the verse over. Like, you dead your whole verse.
But he really was like, oh, like he just caught it, like
damn, yeah.
He knew he messed up, basically. That's why I gave that second round a draw, for real, for real. It didn't go to K-Sean all the way. It was a draw. Real talk. And then, like, the third round was crazy. Mook starts snapping. Talking about, man, keep it 100. Real shit. Like, do you think he tried to save K-Sean?
I mean, that's like asking, did Jesus get stoned? Yeah, he tried to save K-Sean. Like, that's his man. Like, and he was bodying it. Like...
Crazy.
Calico's body
at
him. No reason.
Crazy, dog. Yo, but you know what? Let's move on. We're going to skip the Tay Rock versus O-Red battle. That battle was trash.
And then just to touch on it real fast, it didn't make... you know what? I'm going to jump out the window and say O-Red won just because Tay Rock signed the Dot Mob. How do you sign the Dot Mob?
How do you sign a Dot Mob and you from Maryland?
And you had
how
your
do you
own,
sign a Dot Mob?
You had your own little crew out there, Cavemen or Cave Gang, whatever you was rapping when you battled Tay Rock. I mean,
you talking about Dot? What are you talking about? You from Maryland, cuz?
So I'm gonna get that battle over because you kept it.
All right, Let's move on. Tech Nine, Rich Dollars.
All right.
We don't know who won the toss. Who won the toss? Who the fuck won the toss?
I don't know. I'm not gonna lie to you. But I will say this. I be in the Bronx a lot. Richie, you lost, Rock. You lost. I don't understand how you've been on Smack, I don't know, maybe six or seven times, and you sound the same every fucking battle. Every battle, you sound the same. Don't nothing change about you. Your music videos, you sound like you're battling. I did.
Yo, you know what? I gave round one to Rich Dollars because he had drive. But round two and three went to Tech Nine because it's like Richie just faded away, man.
Yo, Tech Nine.
What's up?
Tech Nine is wild funny, like.
Even wild though, funny. Even you be though, crying, right?
Yeah, even though I still killed you. Yeah. You still my guy. Like, I picked you over Rich Dollars.
All right, moving on. DNA versus Young L. All right.
I'm not going to hold you up. The first round, I gave to DNA. Only because towards the, like, L had a decent first round, but towards the end, it was like, all right, you're lost. I don't know what you're talking about. I don't know what you're talking about. Let's move on to the next round. And then, DNA did his thing.
So you give it to DNA? The whole battle?
No, not the whole battle. Hell no.
Oh, all right. I was about to say, what the
DNA just got the first round. That's it. The second second round, L took it. I think that was the worst performance I've ever seen of any rapper to be like, oh, anybody just say a word and I'm gonna freestyle it. But yet you freestyled it, quote unquote, but you started off with the same line before it. This is crazy or whatever you were saying.
Yeah, and then it's third round. We gonna skip the first and second because you already know DNA won the first, L won the second because he already told the crowd what DNA was gonna do. He used crowd participation. He snapped out talking about, I know you came from grind time, so I know you used to these 1 minute rounds. Woo! Y'all gotta watch that jump. But the third round, it seemed like DNA was spitting old writtens. We don't wanna listen to that. We wanna hear freestyle and hot shit.
That's what it sounds like. He spit an old written, either that or either it was an old written or he tried to do what Avalanche did when he battled Sam Scar in the Fight Club and they went into sudden death. He battled some real shit.
Yeah.
Like some real life shit. But at the end of the day, I'm not trying to be funny. I mean, I don't care how you grew up. I don't want to hear that shit at a URL battle.
All right, moving on.
And another thing I noticed in that, if y'all pay attention, watch Cortez in that battle because it's crazy how Cortez is rapping the shit before DNA even said it. I don't know who's the writer. I don't know if Charlie Tips is writing it and Cortez is proofreading it or if it's the other way around. But I can't respect DNA if you got other niggas writing your battle rap.
That's real shit. Alright, let's move on to the prior, the most controversial battle of the card. Midwest Miles versus Shotgun Shug.
Alright.
What you think? No coin toss. Miles goes first. Miles is the vet. He goes first. He said this little chump ain't nothing. What you think?
The hottest, Young Miles' hottest part in that whole battle was when he walked up to Shug and said, you told proof the rest of hell, bitch ass nigga. And then he walked up on him and said, I do say that shit again, Shug. Shug says, what? Yeah, nigga, I figured that. That was the hottest shit he said.
The whole battle. That was the hottest shit he said the whole battle.
Yeah, that was the hottest shit.
So, but you know, you want to know my outlook on it? I think Shug took it.
Yeah, Shug definitely got this battle.
Yo, how the hell you going to say in your first verse that I don't do that joking shit, I'm a real nigga, but you joke for two rounds straight, Miles? Yeah. Come on. You supposed to be a vet, Miles.
I'm trying to tell you, like, they walked in here with their head up high, like, yo, we the vets, we got this, we battled this person, we battled that person, but now look at you.
That's crazy, man. Like, yo, Shug not even a great rapper. He just a big force.
And then you know what else is crazy too? Not for nothing. Shout out to Calico. Like when Calico battled Shotgun Shug, Shug was wild disrespectful with the whole Detroit situation. You know what I'm saying? And you still held your own. Meanwhile, your man, Young Miles supposed to be the vet, and he was trash. I don't get that.
It's crazy, man. And then what made it so bad, fucking Suge was coming hard all three rounds, like, real shit, real disrespectful. He was giving this nigga shoulder shrugs, head looks, looking at him like, man, I'm the bigger man, nigga.
Yo, did you see when Miles tried to put his hand on his shoulder and he said, yo, get off me, and they was like,
get the fuck off me. His whole spot was like, chill.
Yes, that was smacking Beasley, and I'm like, yo, chill, Miles, chill, don't do nothing.
Damn, like, man, is that boy really to be that feared?
Nah, I mean, I spoke to one of my friends that be in that area that knows Sugar, and they said Sugar.
Oh yeah, so we could believe everything that Sugar be talking about?
From what dude told me, yeah, like Sugar really gets a problem.
So basically boy the fuck out his mind.
Yeah.
Yeah? So this is the type of rapper I should follow if I wanna be a gangbanger.
I mean, unless I heard otherwise, like that's what I'm hearing.
That's what it is. So is all them Grape Street niggas crazy like that, or is it just him?
I don't know.
He the backbone?
I want to say yeah, but I don't know, because I don't know too much about none of them. I happened to ask him where my class, like, yo, you, like, you from North, like, you know what I'm saying? He was like, yeah, like, he really lit at, like, he really was a popular. He was like, surf too, so I said, all right.
Alright, you guys, this was iPod King Carter with PIEvision on our dual comm about Smack URL TV battles, March 27th card. I hope y'all liked it. I hope y'all come back through, you know what I'm saying? Check out more dual comms. Check out my man PIEvision videos. Check out my videos. Listen, any promotion is good promotion. That's my new slogan. So, you know what I'm saying? PIE, tell them what it is, man.
Yeah, please hit the subscribe button. You know, my channel's not for everybody, so no need for you to hit that dislike button. Just move on and give me my view. Now, I mean, you can swallow me on Twitter at PIEvision. Now, I mean, my man iPod King Carter, feel free to please subscribe to that man's channel.
Y'all know where I be at. I be on YouTube and Twitter, man. That's all I do. Oh, also hit up my Facebook page, y'all. I know not too many people into the Facebook life, but holla at my Facebook, man. I get it popping on there too.
Yeah,
we gonna holla at y'all, you know what I'm saying? Watch out for the next video. I hope y'all clicked a couple annotations we got popping, you know what I'm saying? We got the annotation for the subscribe, we got the annotation for the page view, you know what I'm saying? So just do what y'all can do, man. I hope y'all support, because we gonna support y'all. Also, add us as friends. We not scared to add y'all back, so hit us up. Alright, we out of here.
Yeah.